So for this session I'm going to start to get the some of the reflection into the water. So I'm going to take my same blue shadow colour and put some of that brick red into it to make quite a grey brown. And then I'm going to start to bring this into my darker area here. Near my boat reflection. So this is reflecting the harbour wall above it. And then perhaps some the odd ripple at the edge of that dark piece. At the edge there, and then same on this side, need to come darker, just wiggling the brush, leaving a few little holes in the wash. And then I need to change the colour and go bluer now. Turquoise, bit of blue. Going to break into the area around the oranges, which are going to be reflecting from above. So just trying to keep it sort of semi-circular and round feeling. Coming down, making the strokes a little bit larger as I get into the bigger area of open water. Make the ripples a little less intense. Up to the edge of the boat. Coming around the edge. A bit darker into the reflection of the boat itself, so some Payne's grey and some transparent yellow to make a dark green. So this reflection's a lot darker. Coming down here from the back of the boat. Just keeping the movement in the brush. Get it to wiggle and move. Then more green again, more Payne's grey and transparent yellow. We'll bring a bit of that up here. A few more darker marks. Into this area. Then coming across into a lighter area, go more cerulean blue now. So cerulean blue with a little bit of transparent yellow. Just slightly green bring some of these colours in here under this boat. Letting some of the original colours still show through. Cutting in around the back of the boat there. Coming in over to this side of the water. A bit more yellow, a bit more blue. Water. Make it slightly browner now, I think. A bit of Payne's grey in there to muck it up a bit. Bit of the English red, so it's not such a clean colour. Bring it into where these boats are. Work it around the head of my little figure. So a little figure in there, the back of the boat. Get that to link up those two colours. Bring it up a little bit higher towards the harbour wall. A bit more blue and cerulean blue and yellow again. Start to get some of this foreground area in. Link these areas together. More blue, more cobalt blue in that as well. More blue again. Start to work these two areas together. As we get nearer the harbour edge, it just flattens out these marks, much more narrow, more level. Perhaps have a little bit of that just through here. Just to show that we've got some water behind this boat. A few little spots here and there. Link some of these washes together. Then I need some reds. Bit of cadmium red on this left hand side. Just get those colours to work together a bit more. use some cadmium red with a drier brush. So a nice strong bit of red here on this boat. Start to get some of this a bit better, a bit more strength on it. Some of that red on this boat, which will help the base of it to show up some more. Get some of these little buoys to show up. Got some little buoys here. Reds up in the background there. So enough red for the moment. Some stronger colours into this darker area. I want the shadow to be a bit deeper. I'm going to take some of that English red, some Payne's grey, a bit of burnt sienna, use it quite dry, just start to pull out some detail in here, put in some little windows, little bits of detail, find the edge of the building. Little drain pipe or something. Some darks in there. Some of the windows. A few more windows. Just little dots, four little dots. Up the top there. Have a couple on here just slightly, so we'll do these ones as long ones with two dots on top. A few more darks in here. Darks around my crane. Make this stand out a bit more. Just going to get my rigger just to do a bit more drawing with. Couple of windows in this building here. Maybe there's a doorway somewhere there. Possibly we'll have a little figure just somewhere here. Head, a couple of little heads, silhouetted figures. Don't want them too big, just be talking against the light. few colourful shapes, more yellow, slightly stronger. Yellow with some red in it, make them orange. So we have some orange shapes in here. Some of these shapes hanging off of the some sort of rope, some orange shapes on the roof. Colour in the background. And then we need some darker shapes now. I need to get that little figure in down there. So let's make him quite blue, so it doesn't jump out too much. A dark blue grey. Just in here. So body, a bit of a head. It's a bit heavy. Head a bit smaller. And then we had another little figure actually up here on the dock side. It's doing a bit of fishing or something. And I need to pick out my van again so it doesn't get too lost. Take a bit of white just to pick out the top of the roof. Just in here is a bit of a roof on the van. Just to get it to stand out. So we can have some more ropes hanging down. So there's some lighter, whiter shapes in the background there. A few of those in on the dock. The boat actually behind this little figure is pretty light as well. Put a bit of a shape in there. Give this boat a little mooring point coming down somewhere there. Take some dark colour, just some black. Same again, using it very neat. Put some of these marks in. So this one's got some rope or rigging coming up to it there. Something off of the wall. Grey, I did black, make it move a little bit better. That window darker. I've got my little figure here go darker. this in a bit stronger here. Another little rope. In there. Give my little figure a face, some skin tone colour. Take some crimson. Just a bit of red. Tiny bit of ochre in it. Fairly red. Give him an arm there. Seeing as he's in shadow. Get some of the more detailed marks into the building. So I'm going to take a dark orangey brown and just start to get some of these shapes in a bit stronger. The roof lines, edge of the roof, some of that building. Some of those shapes in here. Roof line there, chimneys, edge to the dormer windows, chimneys. The chimneys on these ones. Few marks on these roofs, perhaps a few verticals just to break the up into buildings. A few little windows. Edge to the top of the rock face. More of the orangey brown. A few more slightly darker marks back here. These buildings, just to change it up a bit. A couple of windows. A couple of windows in this one. Darker again. Some darker marks. Lots of bits of rigging and ropes going on there. Also have some bits of scaffolding up here, poles and different bits and pieces. A two more bits of rope and wire, the verticals. Any more dark marks at the base of the, perhaps darken up underneath the wheels. Few dark bits over here, base of the crane. Just give him a darker top. Detail on this boat. A few slightly darker marks back here. Some rigging and stuff on this ship. Some weather vanes and little bits of detail on this boat. Again, little bits of rope and wire hanging off the bow. And darker over here. Darker marks on our ladder. Darker bits here. A few darker marks in this boat. That boat stand out a little bit more. A few darker marks down in the water here, squiggles. The odd bit reflected down into the water here and there. Some blues, similar idea. Cerulean blue, bit of cobalt. Just reflect down some of these colours here and there. Into the water. blue on this boat. Spots in the back here. Got more bits of white. Just clean some of this up. On the bow. Some of that reflected down in the water. Make that a bit lighter there. Brighten it up. Perhaps there's a very light mast on that one. I'm going to put some darker water on this left hand side, so I'm going to use some Payne's Grey and some of the burnt umber or burnt sienna again to make a dark browny grey. I need to get some much darker watermarks on this side. Bring the tone up a bit. It's a bit too light. Continue that down a little bit lower. Just to give the feeling that this left-hand building is casting a bit more shadow into our water area. Slightly darker mucks in here in the water. And again in here, just to link some of this together. A bit more here. Going to put some very, very light greeny grey washes, perhaps a little bit orangey, through the middle rocky area, just to knock some of those whites down. It's a little bit too white. Want a little bit more tone in here. Just to knock this down a bit. think also we could do with a couple, perhaps a couple of birds. Just some little whitish birds. Kind of a coastal scene without a few seagulls. So let's have one perhaps here. If this is a fishing boat, it's probably got some bits of fish and whatnot. Perhaps have a low-lying one down here. Put a very light grey wash through this boat and knock that down a bit. It's a bit bright. Just thought I'd put a little bit more shadow through the front of this fishing boat, so I'm just going to mix up a darkish reddish grey that I can run over the top of this boat to knock it down a bit. It's going to be half in shadow. I don't want it all in shadow. I just want to give the impression that the shadow is maybe being cast across and then obviously into the reflection along the bow at the base of the boat, and then a bit more through the cabin area. Perhaps I could put a light wash through the cabin just to knock that down a bit as well. Might leave a little glint of the cabin showing. Cast some of these into shadow as well on the boat. Bring some of that colour down into water. And then just because he's poking his head out, I've got a bit of light on the top of my little figure. Just in here. He's got a bucket or something there. Could have a bit of light on the top of this little figure as well. Touch on this one. And then I just need a little bit of shadow. Just again a warm grey kind of shadow, just to break up this larger area in the big ship. Just to make some of these shapes a bit more broken up. Perhaps just a little bit of shadow on there as well. And I think with that, the painting is finished.